Welcome to the Sarah Scoop Show. It's time to get the scoop with Sarah.
Hi guys, I'm Laura Osnes. I play Anna in One Royal Holiday. Anna is a nurse in Boston who is headed to her dad's inn in Connecticut for the holidays. And she runs into a mother and son who don't have a place to stay. And Anna, being the kind person that she is, invites them to stay at her family's inn for the night. And unbeknownst to her, it is actually the Queen and Crown Prince of Galwick. They are royalty. And because of weather disasters, they're forced to stay at the inn the whole week leading up to Christmas. And Anna gets to show them what Christmas is like with her family.
Well, it looks absolutely adorable. It looks like such a cute Hallmark movie, and you've got to love anything that has like a royal aspect to it. And I'd love to like know, what was it like reading the script and kind of getting to kind of play around with that? Obviously, you didn't go to a castle, but I don't know if that's in the end, if you get to go to the castle over there. We don't have any spoilers or anything, but just talk about kind of the royal aspect of it.
Yeah, I loved the royal aspect of this script. Falling in love with the prince, I mean, I can't complain. I loved it. I like cried when I read this script. I thought it was so sweet. I really love how like she has an effect on him. Like she softens him and helps him like have a good time and loosen up a little bit. And he also believes in her. She has been kind of burned by love and isn't really looking for it at all. And she helps other people sometimes at the expense of helping herself. And, you know, he helps her realize that. But we did actually find a castle. You will see a castle in the scouts. Were incredible, because like it was all within like a 20-minute radius where these two beautiful inns that we shot at, as well as this random castle in Connecticut that I had no idea even existed. But we got to shoot there for one day. It was only one day, but it was magical.
Oh, that's so cool. Yeah, definitely. There's some historic things up in the New England area, so that's really cool. And it's interesting. So did you film everything in Connecticut, not in Vancouver?
Yes. So we filmed the entire movie in the month of July in Connecticut. And I think that's why they got so many Broadway performers, because we were all East Coast and they wanted to find people that teamed together there. So yeah, we shot it all in Connecticut. It was definitely Christmas in July. Most of the movie, it was like 85 degrees outside and we were like boiling in our sweaters and winter coats, but it added to the fun. It was great.
I don't know how to pronounce his last name because it's a little bit of a tricky one, but Aaron, obviously from Les Mis. I'd love to know, just like working with him, what was that like?
I loved getting to work with Aaron Tveit. We've known each other actually for a long time. We both work on Broadway and do theater in New York, and we've actually done a few concerts together, but haven't done like a full project like this where we've gotten to play opposite each other. So I was so thrilled when I found out he was cast, and he's so good in this role. You guys are going to love it. And yes, I was of course a fan of Les Mis, and I had seen him in Les Mis, but I knew him before Les Mis actually. So I'm a fan of all of his Broadway work as well, and his whole like concert career and all of that, and his other TV stuff. I actually haven't watched Graceland. He's filming something now in Vancouver, but he's been all over the place and doing it all. And so I was, yes, thrilled to get to work with him.
Yeah, it's awesome. It's nice to see different faces too. Obviously, you've done a couple of other Hallmark movies, but it's nice to see some new faces on the channel. Or do you think this is going to be something you start doing? Like, because that's a big deal. Once you get your foot in the door, they love bringing you back. Do you think you're going to come back for some more?
Totally. I would be honored. I have just had so much fun, you know, getting into that Hallmark family. And I'm like, if I could do like one or two Hallmark movies a year, like, that would be amazing. I would absolutely love it. I've just had such a great time, such wonderful experiences. It's been a lovely place to get to learn, because I've done mostly stage stuff. So I feel like I'm kind of just getting into doing TV film. It's so fun. And they just keep re-airing them. And like every once in a while, I'm like, oh my gosh, my movie's on again today. And it's such the content is so sweet, especially for families to, you know, all be able to sit down around the TV and watch a heartwarming Christmas movie together. It's great. And I've gotten to sing in all the movies too, which is just so fun.
Show off your many talents. That's fun. Do you have any other maybe projects in the works with Hallmark yet?
You know, I don't at this moment. They usually are pretty like quick to turn around. So it's not like these things are set like a year in advance. I would love to do another one. We've all been keeping our fingers crossed for maybe a sequel to One Royal Holiday. Like, who doesn't want to see One Royal Wedding, right? Like, so we'll see. We'll see. We're putting it out there. But yes, I don't have anything officially in the works at this moment, but would be thrilled anytime.
Yeah, and they've done a few sequels, but nothing to my knowledge with royal sequels. So this will be a great one for sure. And then kind of changes settings and everything. That would be great. So hopefully, fingers crossed.
Yes, me too. Thank you.
And do you have a favorite scene that you got to film? I know everything happens so quickly, like about 3 weeks, but what was your favorite scene to film?
Yeah, I loved it all. It really is such a sweet movie. And, you know, getting to work with your friends is always the best. And we were just so grateful to be there in the midst of everything that was going on in the world. But I think one of my favorite scenes, there's two, there's a ball at the end. So we're all dressed up, getting to go to the ball. And I get to dance. Aaron and I share a waltz that we actually choreographed together in the parking lot at the inn. So that was really special to get to kind of film that, knowing that we kind of like helped create it. And then we also take a carriage ride. And I remember that night, it was so beautiful. Like the stars were out. It was actually kind of like 60 degrees. So it actually felt like at least cool. It wasn't blazing hot. And we got to just ride in a carriage for like 4 hours while we did that carriage scene. And it was super sweet.
Oh yeah, that sounds magical. And I'm sure I can imagine how fun it is. Obviously, you're a performer on stage. The costumes and everything are so extravagant, but getting to like dress up for a royal ball, I bet that was fun. And were you like super excited about your dress that they picked for you?
Yes, it's gorgeous. It was like very like Grace Kelly. It had this like sweetheart strapless, like shimmering gold. I don't want to give too much away, but you there's a couple pictures out there already of me in it. Yeah, I felt like a princess. Very great wardrobe decision.
Oh yeah, I always love the big dresses, like for obviously a lot of the royal ones when the, I guess, I don't know, commoner comes to the ball and you have this moment and you're just like, oh wow. So I'm sure you will have this. I can't wait to see it.
Thank you. I don't get the tiara. You know what I mean? It's like, I'm the commoner mm-hmm. going to the ball, but I get to dress up all the same and fall in love with the prince. It's so great.
Oh yeah, who wouldn't want that? For sure, Meghan Markle's living that life. But I'd love to know, obviously you got to reunite with your co-star Victoria Clark from Cinderella, which that's so fun getting to get, I guess, reminisce about the other good times you used to have. What was it like getting to work with her in this capacity?
Yeah, it was so special. Speaking of royalty, yeah, Vicky and I did Cinderella on Broadway together in 2013, and she was my fairy godmother, and she plays the queen in this movie. And I actually was the one who had a conversation with our director and like put her name in the hat. Like I kind of suggested her for the film. I'm so glad it all like came through and happened, because she's an extremely dear friend of mine. I call her Mama Bear. She's like a second mother. I've always looked up to her so much. She's become such a mentor of mine over the years. And it was just a joy to get to work with her again and essentially live together. You know, the whole cast and crew were quarantined together while we shot the movie. So, you know, we shared meals from a distance, like, you know what I mean? And after we were all there for 2 weeks and we were getting COVID tests, you know, regularly. And so, you know, we were able to become a little more of a family the longer we were there, but I was so, so grateful to have her there on this journey. And I adore her so much. And she's so good in the film too. She just has this regal essence about her.
Yeah, that's really fun. I bet, like you kind of said, quarantining, you guys spent a lot of time together. And I bet it was great to get to see her again after about, like you said, 7 years. So that's awesome. Were you a fan of Hallmark Channel before you booked In the Key of Love? Was that ever something that was on your radar?
Honestly, I wasn't. And I wish I would have, because after doing In the Key of Love, it's now like all I want to watch. So I'm definitely a Hallmark convert fan now for sure. And yeah, I have some other friends who have done them now, and they're just always so fun to watch. And yeah, I'm so glad I'm now on the Hallmark train, because I've totally fallen in love with them.
Yeah. And it's like I said, it's so nice to have new faces, because they have some people who've been on there for years and it's always fun to see them. But I think it's always nice to have like a breath of fresh air, and you are definitely that. So that's awesome.
Thank you. So sweet. Thanks.
And did this opportunity just come up like a regular audition, or did they just offer you the role? I just love to know. Obviously you've done a couple others. I just kind of, let's start from the beginning. How did you start your relationship? Just an audition, and then now it's turned into three projects?
You know, Hallmark is very loyal. And so I think it is kind of a hard family to kind of get into. I was so grateful. I knew one of the producers of In the Key of Love, and he pitched my name to the director, knowing that the role had to sing. And he's been in kind of the Broadway circle for a while. So, and the director like knew who I was, and I got an offer for the role. So I didn't ever audition for it. And I was, again, like shocked and grateful and thrilled just because I haven't had much TV experience. So I thought this is going to be an amazing opportunity for me to get to learn. Claire Nieder-Perrone was the director of that movie, and she was absolutely fantastic, like took me under her wing and helped me learn how to fly because I was so anxious about it. It's very different being on set as it is being, you know, on a stage. Yeah, I feel like I learned so much. And then I was, again, just so grateful to that they wanted me back. I got to do Homecoming for the Holidays last Christmas. And then this year in quarantine, same thing. I got a call with an offer. So I'm lucky. I feel so blessed that I just kind of have my foot in the door now. And they've been happy enough to invite me back for more movies. And I hope it happens again.
And you definitely didn't need to like prove yourself that you had the connection with the producer because you're obviously a Broadway star. I'd go ahead and say Broadway royalty, which is ironic, obviously, one royal holiday. But yeah, that's awesome.
Thank you. It is very different though. I've been doing stage stuff my entire life, but I'd only ever done like two guest spots on TV stuff. And so to suddenly lead a movie was an exciting challenge and a really cool adventure that I, again, felt very grateful to get to go on, especially in the Hallmark family and under that umbrella.
Oh, for sure. And then we're going to kind of switch gears a little bit to all the other amazing things that you've done. And I saw that you were in Fosse Verdon, which is so cool. Would you want to talk about, like, I don't know how big of a role that was, but oh my gosh, Michelle Williams and Sam Rockwell, that's huge. What was that like for you?
Yeah, I got to shoot Fosse Verdon and it was awesome. I initially auditioned for a different role and didn't get that one and then got offered the role of Shirley MacLaine. So I play young Shirley MacLaine and she literally has two lines on page 3 of the pilot episode. So it's very quick and I was just on set for one day, but I had a scene with Michelle Williams and Sam Rockwell, like gave me a hug and I said my two lines and then we left together. So it was very cool experience. And I knew the team. I know Tommy Kail and Andy Blankenbuehler, who the director and choreographer of Fosse Verdon. They're Broadway folks. So I knew both of them and was, again, grateful that they like not threw me a bone as Shirley MacLaine. Like that was great. But I initially had auditioned for a different character. And then they were like, oh, maybe Laura would be great for this one instead. And so it was fun. I got to wear like a red wig and like really kind of outlandish makeup and you know, be young Shirley. It was very cool.
That is super cool. Oh my gosh. What a fun experience. Even though it was a short one, I bet that you'll always remember that.
Totally. Oh, I will always remember it. And Nicole Fosse, you know, Bob Fosse's daughter was there on set and she's kind of in charge of making sure everything is, you know, being told truthfully. And it was very, very cool experience. I thought the series turned out really beautifully.
Oh, and the critics obviously did also win so many awards. That's so that you got to be a part of such a huge thing, which is so cool.
I was very honored to be a part of it for sure.
And I'd love to let's rewind a little bit back to your beginnings as a performer. How did you get started?
I have wanted to be on Broadway since I was like 3 years old. And I did my first original, my first show. I played a munchkin in The Wizard of Oz when I was in third grade. And the bug bit, I've been doing theater and musicals kind of ever since. I went to college only for a year at the University of Wisconsin. And I studied musical theater there, but then got offered a job back in Minneapolis. I'm from Minneapolis, to work at a theater there for a year and intern. So I kind of just started working. And then in 2007, I did a TV reality show that cast me as Sandy in Grease on Broadway. And so that was like my big break. And I ended up winning that competition I got to play Sandy for a year and then have now been in New York for 13 years and done 6 Broadway shows.
Goodness. Well, it kind of sounds like it happened pretty quickly for you.
It did. I was 21 when I did the reality show. So like, yes, I worked hard and this is something I've wanted to do my whole life and taking voice lessons, dance lessons, and getting a lot of experience and stuff like that. But that reality show, I never would have thought that would have been my path or, you know, the way I would have gotten to Broadway to fulfill my dream. I'm so grateful for it, but it was also like a crazy experience. Like I have a little like reality show PTSD from like being put in that situation, like singing for my survival on national television. But also, yeah, it made my dream come true. So it's been really, I look back and I go like, wow, like what if I had stayed in school? Like how it's such a unique path. It's never happened again. Like we haven't done a Broadway reality show since then in 2007. So I'm grateful, but it was crazy.
There's another one, gosh, I think it was a little bit before that, was for Elle Woods for the Legally Blonde the musical, and they had like a reality version. So it kind of sounds like that.
Yeah, I was going to say the one with Elle Woods was a little bit different because America didn't vote. That was more like a televised audition process. In ours, we sang live on TV every week and America called in and voted like American Idol, as where that one was up to like the casting agencies. So they were a little different, but yes, similar idea for sure.
That's kind of neat though. Like with yours, I like how the public votes. That should kind of like almost give you even more of a boost. It's like the American public loved you and they picked you. So gosh, what an opportunity for sure.
I know. I like feel like I won like Miss America or something. I was like, oh, I have you all to thank for helping my Broadway dream come true. So thank you.
And you've obviously done so many for like, gosh, a few years now. Do you have a favorite role that sticks out in your mind that you were just like, gosh, if I could go back and do that forever, I would do it?
Oh, also so hard. I feel like it's like choosing your favorite child. And like, they're all special for different reasons. If I had to go back if I could go back and do one again, I think it would be Bonnie and Clyde, because we only ran 2 months on Broadway. So I feel like she didn't get her due. Cinderella was magical and iconic, and I would do that again in a heartbeat. But I think the most meaningful one to me, maybe it's because it was most recent, was a musical called Bandstand. It was a brand new show, and it was about a group of war vets who returned from World War II, and I played a war widow. And it's all about them healing from the traumas of war, and we really tried to honor people who have served our country. And so that was very like fulfilling. I feel like we were part of something bigger than ourselves. And it was, yeah, definitely the most kind of like rewarding thing I've done in my career.
Yeah, a little bit more serious in nature, but I'm sure super impactful, which is great that you can kind of have the lighthearted and the serious and still reach people. And do you have maybe a dream role that you hope you get to play one day?
Yes. Oh my gosh. My dream role is like Marion Peru in The Music Man. I've done the show twice. Throughout my youth, I played Amaryllis and Zanita, two of the other characters, and now I want to play Marion. I think it would be so fun to do like a tap show as well, either like Polly and Crazy for You or Peggy Sawyer in 42nd Street, or maybe like Millie and Thoroughly Modern Millie. Let's see, Light in the Piazza, I would love to do. Maybe like being a princess again, like doing Belle and Beauty and the Beast would just be, it would be so fun. Those are a few. Maybe Eliza Doolittle, My Fair Lady.
Oh, yeah. That one's a great one, of course. Oh, wow. Gosh, so many. You can't choose. Well, I'm sure you'll get to do all of them. And before we finish up, I want to know, like, obviously with coronavirus and Broadway's on pause until I read May 2021, which is, just, gosh, so long. Do you know any idea about when you might get back on the stage so people can get to experience how talented you are?
Thank you. So sweet. I actually, of all things, just today filmed a concert that is going to be live streamed starting November 6th. So I've been advertising that on my social media. So you can follow along if you're interested in checking that out. But I think what we're starting to do in our industry is video content to be able to be streamed or purchased, you know, that way. So you can watch it from your computer at home, which is not the same. And, you know, I think it's hard because our business thrives off of large groups of people coming together to experience live theater. That's why it's live. And some of that can be captured through a screen and some of that can't. So it's going to be a very slow process coming back to Broadway, but I know we will recover. And I've been actually very inspired by how creative artists have gotten during this time to continue to put art and joy out into the world.
Yes, definitely. You've got to find different avenues and ways to just get that out there. And it's happening. I know Dua Lipa has a big, like, crazy virtual concert coming up. Kind of, I don't know if it's going to be anything like yours, but it's live streamed. It'll be interesting. So definitely people will love to watch yours. And you said it can be found on your social media.
Yeah. This concert is just me. It's my like cabaret, like club act. So it's not going to be like a huge thing, but it's me and my pianist.
It's awesome. It's all, I call this show The Paths Not Taken, and it's all songs from shows or roles I almost did in my career, but then didn't. So it's kind of a unique twist to see me get to do things that I'm actually not known for.
Oh, I like that. That's so unique. And you kind of get to tap into like maybe like these dream roles you just mentioned and get to still get to perform in that way. That's really cool.
Exactly.
So it all works out. Well, when, and you said, when will this be airing? In November?
Yes. You can buy tickets through BroadwayWorld.com. Broadway World has partnered with Birdland Jazz Club, which is the venue that the performance is at. And there are, it's released starting, I believe, November 6th, and then it's available for a month. So you buy a ticket for November 6th is the premiere date, and then you can have access to the concert for a month after.
Perfect. Well, I will make sure to include those links so people can definitely go watch it and get some tickets. But thank you so much for taking the time to talk to me today.
I love that. Thank you. Thank you. Of course. Thank you for having me, and thanks for all your support.
Thank you for watching The Sarah Scoop Show. Head to sarahscoop.com for more.